I'm a journalist. I got my job, first job straight out of uni at 21. But I do love being a journalist. But I think the media industry has a problem of diversity, and I started to notice that when I was the only black person in the office. The fact that there was a lack of coverage when it came to black issues, celebrities, stars. And I thought, well, if I've got these skills to be a journalist, why don't I make my own platform? There's nothing out there that really talks to black women directly. I run a media platform called Black Ballad, a lifestyle media platform for black women in Britain. Platform has a bit of a twist. Members pay a certain amount a month, either $4.99 or $6.99 a month, and that gives them access to all content. It gives them access to discounts of black-owned businesses we've partnered with, and it gives them discounts to the events we run each month. Anything I write, anything I do, we don't take any money out of the business. So for me to survive, I will freelance, which really makes it possible for me to run my business. If I didn't have those freelance opportunities, I wouldn't be able to run this business. I definitely wish I was taught about money more at school. I remember coming home and my dad said, there's two things you'll need to know, mental maths and percentages. And he was like, if you can do basic mental maths with money and percentages, you'll be fine. I can do that, like in a restaurant, and that helps. I do not use algebra in my business. I don't do 2A plus 3B and whatever it is. No, I think there needs to be a practical side, and I think it would empower a lot more women actually if they were learn about money in school. Because I think boys are pushed into maths and boys are pushed into handling money. And I really liked, and I think that was the great thing about my dad, that he was really pushy about me being able to handle money and teaching me about, you know, when he went away, I actually would run the household and like when bills would be paid and stuff. And I think that's just given me a great foundation. Like I'm very confident in terms of having a discussion about money. I think social media has really changed how we think about money. I think it puts pressure on us to have more money, because you have to be able to buy things to show off, to create an image, whether it be having money to go on holiday so you can do the Fry Gap shot that everyone does, or you can put what shoes you bought on Instagram stories, or whether you can, you know, do another Instagram story about the car you just bought because you work so hard at work. Social media puts pressure on us to make more money, and I think a lot of people probably use money that's not theirs to buy items that give them a social media profile or image. It's really hard to navigate that and not be tempted to fall into that trap. We have events every month, but tonight is our big flagship event. It's Black History Month in October. So we do an event every year called Cocktails and Conversations. And it is about black women in a safe space telling their truths, their journey, giving words of wisdom to other black women. Tonight's lineup features Benjamina from last year's Bake Off, and our keynote speaker is Jamelia. It's pretty nerve-wracking, this event, because it's the one we have to get right. Nothing can go wrong, because it's kind of the event we're known for.
Do what you love. I know it's a bit cheesy, it's on the board there as well, but I would urge you, if there's anything that just niggling, passion, that idea you've got and you just have no clue how you're going to get there, what it even looks like, work on it, speak with people who you trust. We're all such talented women and we have such amazing skills to offer the world, so don't let it go to waste, work on it.
I hope the future of Black Ballad is that we are recognised as the leading publisher in black British lifestyle content in Europe. I want to compete with Ebony and Essence in America. And I want all black women to know what Black Ballad is. Even if you don't read it, even if you don't think it's for you, I want it to be like when black women mention Black Ballad, they're like, yeah, I know what it is.